I am the Grinch. There's no Christmas without the Grinch. Never, never, never tell them why you like the Grinch.
I like the Grinch because there's no meaning of Christmas without the Grinch.
Where's Max? He's my favorite. I love the Grinch.
I want to be a Grinch when I grow up.
Santa ain't nothing like the Grinch.
You see, Christmas, the Grinch, I am everything. There's no Christmas without me, the Grinch.
We love the Grinch. That's what Christmas is all about.
You're a mean one. You really are here. You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an ear. Mr. Grinch. Bad banana.
Mr. Grinch.
With the greasy black peel. You're a vile one. You got termites in your smile. You have all the tender sweetness of a seasick crocodile.
Mr. Grinch. You're a foul one. Friends you don't have none.
I wouldn't touch you with a 39 and a half foot pole.
Was the month of Christmas, and all through the town, the Grinch was feeling himself, from his feet to his crown. His eyes, his clothes, his smile, his hair, he walked as if on a runway, without a doubt or a care. Children flocked to his side, hoping to catch his swag, pushing and shoving in line, for the Grinch had secured the bag. He was on every billboard and in every store. On Facebook, on Twitter, there was Grinch galore. Yes, it would appear that the Grinch had learned fame. Popular and rich, Grinch was a household name. Yes, all this attention had gone straight to his head. And rather than the true meaning of Christmas, the Grinch was celebrating himself instead.
It's about time Christmas got fun. All I want to do is play video games and don't think about anyone.
Yeah, I want to grow to be just like the Grinch. Have ladies, travel, and be filthy rich.
Man, me too. As soon as I get through this line, I'm going to ask the Grinch exactly how to steal a PS5.
I'm going to ask for one too. And an extra controller.
And I'm gonna ask how to steal a new bike, iPhone, and a plan for Motorola.
Yeah, well, you have to wait because I'm gonna get to him first.
And that's when the tension began to quickly burst. The Grinch and his fans, so it may seem, had become quite distracted by material things. But just as matters began to go far amiss, came a voice of reason in the form of Grandma Chris.
Hey! What's up with you?
What's up with me? I'll give you a clue. Oh, you out here embarrassing us and acting like fools.
Man, I hate Christmas time. People like you are always walking around and telling us what to do.
Well, somebody needs to. Y'all out here acting a mess, following after this Grinch, who certainly is not acting his best.
The Grinch is getting money, and that's what I need too, because people are not getting paid like they used to.
Now see, you barking up the wrong tree. It's not the Grinch you should be looking for. It's somebody bigger than he.
No one's bigger than the Grinch. He's about to get a Nike contract.
And how do you think that happened? Let's take a look back. Not long ago, the Grinch was all by himself. He was loathsome and mean and just came into wealth. And it's not about the stuff you're looking for today. He learned to love from God and God's people. It's the only way. It's the gift of love in and out of season that makes people like Grinch change for a very good reason. This hope, this joy, it reminds everyone of the birth, the death, and the resurrection of God's only Son.
How did I get here? I've come so far,
said the Grinch, recognizing his actions inspired grave consequence.
Grandma Chris is right. This is no way to act. I just got so excited. I just didn't look back.
It's all right, Grinch. We all make mistakes. Thank you, Grandma Chris, for reminding us it's a better way.
I can't believe I was about to ask how to lie, cheat, and steal. If my mom found about that, I'd be in trouble for real.
Listen, kids. At first, Grinchy tricks seem to be fantastic. But I have to admit, they do get a bit drastic. Christmas isn't for losers. It's actually quite fun. The lights, the food, the cake with the rum.
Not Grinch. You know that's not important.
It's that you're not alone, that you're loved. And know this, no matter how far we go, no matter how far we stray, God's love will always find us. It's a love that always stays.
And what happened then? Well, some people say that the Grinch's heart grew 3 more sizes that day. He learned to repent and gave his life to Christ, promising no matter what to try and live right. And that's when the true meaning of Christmas finally shone through, and the Grinch and his new friends found love times 2. With smiles in their souls and Jesus' love burning bright, they knew better than to argue about toys, fuss, or fight. And that Grinch, once full of material wealth, remembered that Christmas is about the birth of Jesus and not about self.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Her King, let every heart prepare him room, let heaven and nature sing.
Everybody sing! joy, to the world sing joy.